So what are we doing here? Setting up a new station here out in Erie, Fairpoint, Mason Farms. First things first, we had to find the position of the weather station by taking the weather station out, using the receiver, plugging it in, make sure we have a good signal out here. Next is getting the 4x4 in the ground. Use the 10-foot 4x4, put it in the ground. We put it in real deep here, sandier soil. Next, we're just going to mount it, brace the 4x4, get the weather station up, and then we have to go into the office and we have to register his weather station at Rainwise, where the data will get collected, and from there on we can enter him into metadata into the NEWA system, where the Rainwise system can communicate with the NEWA system. We can get his weather station up.
Right now we're just putting the stand up for the weather station, the Rainwise MK weather station. We put the location here out in the central yard where we have no solar or no shadow from the trees around us. We're just trying to level it, and we're going to put on the attachment so we can put the Rainwise up. And for the install, we just use a simple 4x4, 10 feet. Dug a hole, leveled it.
Now some farmers, they don't want it because they're afraid they'll crack the, run into the 4x4, and then next thing you know, you got concrete in your dirt that you gotta break up, get the jackhammer out for it.
We're just installing a leaf wetness sensor, or on the bottom of the rain bucket.
And then you gotta mount the soil loop panel.
And then when you put this, it's important to put your solar panel towards the south to get the most sun. Let's find true south.
You have to be tall to do that job.
Or get a ladder. And we're pointing it towards true south, which is...
Yeah, the next thing to check is if the bucket's actually level. So right here we're looking at the Rainwise MKLR Long Range 3 model. It comes with your station here with the tipping rain gauge, your leaf wetness sensor, and a solar panel with your weather vane on top. It comes with a little receiver called an IP100, which is required to have an internet connection in a house or a barn somewhere. We test the signal, whether or not the weather station can get signal at your farm. Your data to your machine is getting logged in at their dashboard, and we also cooperate with them where their data comes to our NEWA site. We like to keep intervals at about 15 minutes collecting data and sending it in. Right now we're trying to level the rain gauge bucket so it works how it's supposed to, with the tipping rain gauge mechanism on the inside needs to be balanced.
We're in the final part of the installation of the weather machine, and we need your IP100 connected to a network and be able to connect the radio signal to the weather station we just set up. So we're just trying to find a good location in the owner's barn here with the router where we can get internet and the radio signal. The last step in the process is registering the Rainwise weather station and IP100 into the Rainwise dashboard site. So then the owner can go on and log, and you can track all your data, and it's collected on the internet. You have to register the MAC address and serial number, and then they sync.
Then we have to sign them up for the metadata sheet for NEWA so we can get all the information onto the NEWA site.